Today we're going to discuss a delivery service that earlier this year raised $1.15 billion. Currently in the rideshare space, there's two major players. You have Uber and Lyft. But in the delivery space, there's a lot more. You've got Doordash, you've got Grubhub, you've got Postmates, you've got grocery delivery, Instacart, Shipt. And there's another delivery service that we're going to discuss today, and it's called GoPuff. I'd say the best way to describe GoPuff is that it's a mobile gas station. They have tons of items from cleaning supplies and over-the-counter medicine to food, drinks, electronics, baby essentials, and more. And they deliver fast. They say on average you get your order in just 30 minutes. And they also have a flat $1.95 delivery fee on all orders. They also deliver alcohol, but that includes an additional fee of up to $2. And they also have what's called their GoPuff Fam membership service. And with that, you get free delivery on all orders for just $5.95 a month. And they have over 300 facilities delivering to over 550 cities. All right, so that's how it works from the customer's perspective. But what about the delivery partners that actually deliver the goods? So again, it's like a mobile convenience store or gas station. Unlike Postmates or DoorDash, you're not delivering any restaurant food, just goods. And you get the items that you deliver from a centrally located warehouse. You don't have to go to a store or a restaurant or anything like that to get the items. You go to the warehouse. It's similar to Amazon Flex, if you've done Amazon Flex. You go to the warehouse, you get the order, and you just deliver it. And in some markets, they deliver tobacco and alcohol, so you'll have to scan the customer's ID to make sure that they're of age. And when you deliver an order, the customer will sign off on the delivery on your phone to confirm that it has been delivered. The requirements to become a driver are pretty standard. You need to be at least 21 years old, have a valid license, vehicle and registration, own a smartphone, and also be willing and able to pass a prepaid alcohol delivery training course. And again, GoPuff is available in over 550 cities, so it's all over the country. So the next question is, how much can GoPuff drivers make? The payment structure is very similar to other platforms. You have the base fee per delivery, you have tips, and you also have mileage compensation. And GoPuff currently offers a guaranteed minimum rate per hour. This does vary by city, but to give you an idea, a delivery partner in the Aurora, Colorado area said his guaranteed minimum rate is $14 per hour. And he also said that when he works a 10-hour plus shift, his rate goes up to $18 per hour. And according to a few different sources online like Glassdoor or Indeed, drivers on average are earning anywhere from $13 to $15 per hour. And in order to become a GoPuff driver, you apply right on their website in just a few minutes. We'll leave a link for this page in the description. All right, now let's look at some pros and cons of being a GoPuff delivery driver. As far as the pros, again, you deliver items from a central location. And because you're not going all over the place, this puts less mileage and strain on your car, and you'll always know where you're headed to deliver. And they also have that guaranteed minimum rate, so there could be times where you're getting paid for basically doing nothing. And as far as some cons, there may be times where you have to deal with cash payments. Although right now, during the pandemic, they are not accepting cash payments. But outside of a pandemic, if you are accepting cash payments, this could make it a little less safe for you as a driver, having to carry that cash around. It's just nice with all the other services, rideshare and delivery, that it's all electronic. It's nice to not have to deal with cash payments, just cash tips. And another con is either having to handle orders for minors or having to ID customers for tobacco or alcohol. All right, so that's GoPuff. Again, it's like a mobile convenience store. You deliver items from a central location. But what do you guys think of GoPuff? Is it something that interests you? Leave a comment below and let us know. We will leave a link in the description if you are interested in becoming a driver where you can sign up. Thanks again for watching. Please like, comment, or subscribe and drive safe. Thanks.